We'll be discussing the incidence of cardiovascular disease in our country. As we know, by 2020, India is going to be the capital for cardiovascular disease all over the world. 1/4 of the total number of cardiovascular disease over the world will be in India by 2020 end. Blood pressure and diabetes and cholesterol abnormalities would form the deadly triad. And all these three conditions are going to increase the risk of cardiovascular disease, particularly in young people below the age of 40 years, by up to the incidence of 70 to 80%. Tobacco smoking as well as tobacco chewing and smoking, both of them are going to be another very, very important reversible cause of cardiovascular disease. Technically, there is no terminology like classical symptom, because as the disease evolves over a period of time, symptoms also become more and more variable. The commonest symptom is heaviness in the left side of the chest. But in today's era, even right side of the chest, if somebody gets discomfort, pain in the upper arm or the forearm, pain in the tips of the shoulders, pain at the back, pain in the jaw while walking, and most importantly, feeling of gastritis or burning sensation in the lower side of the chest can almost occur in 9 out of 10 patients coming to the hospital with heart attack. So whenever a person has a suspicion, or the doctor has a suspicion that this person is suffering from a heart attack, the first thing that needs to be done is take an early transport and reach a tertiary care hospital where the facilities for an angiography, angioplasty and critical care are available. The medicine that the doctor can give is 325 milligrams of dispirin. It's a chewable tablet that needs to be chewed. Another tablet is called clopidogrel, with 6 or 8 tablets can be taken, and atorvastatin 80 milligrams. One caution is important, that sublingual sorbitrate or nitrate, in today's era, we generally avoid giving them, because that can decrease the blood pressure and people can have catastrophic events. Diet forms a major non-pharmacological form to reduce the incidence of cardiovascular disease. In our country, there are various customs, particularly north, south, east and west. But the commonest thing that we need to do is please reduce the total amount of calories that we take in our body throughout the day. Reduce the incidence of simple carbohydrates like rice as well as chapati. Increase the intake of fresh green leafy vegetables, fruits, as well as dal and other proteins which are there, particularly vegetarian. And in non-veg, egg yellow as well as cheese has got pretty good fat content which is there. Avoid meat and reduce the incidence of chicken. That would probably take care of your cholesterol abnormality, and the chances of developing sugar and blood pressure also decreases drastically. Heart disease generally, and very rarely, less than 5% of individuals who have heart problem can be because of family history. So that is why very important in the early days to understand that if any of your family members, maternal or paternal side, has got a history of heart attack, angioplasty or bypass surgery done below the age of 50 years for a male and below the age of 60 years for a female, is considered to be a strong family history. But the chances are very less, and predominantly heart disease occur because of acquired lack of physical activity and sedentary lifestyle with abnormal dietary patterns. Coronary angiography is a method to identify blockage in the heart arteries. It can be done by two ways. One is a non-invasive method, which is called CT coronary angiography, exactly the way a CT scan is being done, and the procedure takes almost 15 to 20 minutes to do the procedure. And the second, the gold standard, is the invasive coronary angio, in which there is a small catheter which is placed into the right side of the hand or through the leg. It can be done through two routes, and that is the gold standard to confirm whether the person has blockages, the percentage of blockages, the flow into the coronary arteries, and the calcium that the person is harboring in the coronary arteries. It's a relatively simple procedure. Procedure time is just 2 to 3 minutes. It is done as a daycare procedure and the patient can be discharged before evening. It is absolutely safe and the complication rate is one in less than 1 in 1 lakh patients. So this is an eternal dilemma or a controversy that has been occurring from the mid 90s when the stents came into vogue. Angioplasty and bypass are two forms of therapy to treat coronary artery disease. As you know, if a road is being affected and the road is bad, either you put cement over it and clear the block over the road, or you create a new road from the beginning of the problem to the end of the problem and bypass that abnormal bad road and create a new road. So the first procedure is an angioplasty, where I rectify the root cause where the problem is by putting in a stent, and bypass surgery is generally done by open heart surgery and you put in new grafts to the patient's arteries. Generally, the pros and cons of every procedure needs to be talked about. So I'll talk to you that if the patient is young, patient is a non-diabetic, patient's heart pumping capacity is lesser, and the patient is a non-tobacco smoker or a non-tobacco chewer, generally angioplasty is preferable to bypass surgery. In a patient who has multiple blocks, more than 4 or 5, who's going to require more number of stents, is diabetic, doesn't have a healthy lifestyle, probably in those situations, bypass may fare better than an angioplasty. But in today's era, with the kind of new stent technologies coming in, majority of the patients, other than left main disease, are generally the best for angioplasty, and the success rate of this procedure is close to above 95%.